Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, we're going to talk about a rather controversial topic. We're going to talk about DACs. How important are they, and how you should make a buying decision? So we see this very often. Manufacturers put a marketing name to their DACs. And we're seeing also people are asking about, you know, X DAC number versus X DAC number. Now, I have to say that the DAC chip is actually not that important. How the DAC is implemented in the output stage, the analog side of things, it's more important than the DAC chip. Now, the chip number is always going to be changed, you know, as chips improve. Now, the number itself, the higher number, doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be better. It's just that it's a newer architecture. You know, sometimes it could be better, sometimes it might not be. Sometimes it's just marketing to show you that, look, we're innovating again. Here's the new number of this chip. Just like CPUs on a computer, right? It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be significantly better, maybe marginally. We see this all the time. Manufacturers would say, for example, multi-bit DAC. Well, yeah, technically speaking, the DAC is multi-bit. Any DAC is multi-bit because a CD quality file is 16 bits, and that's more than one bit, so it's multi-bit. And also some manufacturers will say their DACs are field programmable, FPGA. This technology has been around for a long time. Many manufacturers have used it in audio and non-audio environments. All that aside, you shouldn't really make a buying decision based on the marketing fluff. What you should do is look at the manufacturer's reputation, right? Are they known for making high quality DACs? Their previous products, are they well reviewed, right? People that you trust. When you're looking at the DAC itself, right, if you have access to photos, what's inside the box, look at the output stage, right? The power supply is critical for any audio equipment. If it has a good size power supply, if it has good output stage, so does it have a good power supply for the digital stage, right? You know, not just the analog stage. I'll give you a quick example in this photo. I took the manufacturer's name off the board so you can see what it is, but it is a pretty expensive DAC. It's about $3,500. Can you see where the chip is in this picture? Now, you can pause this video if you have trouble seeing it. Now, this picture, I've circled the DAC chip. As you can see, this DAC is a tiny piece of a large puzzle. It's like a 1,000-piece puzzle game, right? And, you know, the DAC is only one piece of it. This shows you a visual example of what I'm trying to tell you. You shouldn't buy a DAC based on the DAC chip, and you shouldn't dismiss a DAC based on the DAC chip. So what is important is look at the features that it has. Does it meet your needs? Look at the inputs and outputs. Look at the manufacturer of the DAC. And also, if you can, listen to it. It's more important is to listen to it. No matter whose review that you watch or read about, everyone's opinion is their own and might or may or may not agree with your opinion. Do that because everybody's system is going to be different. Many manufacturers have pretty good return policy, so you can buy it, and if you don't like it, send it back. Even if they have to charge you a restocking fee, I look at the restocking fee as an education, right? So say, for example, if you bought a DAC that's $1,000 and they have a 10% restocking fee, $100 is really not that much to educate yourself on what you like and what you don't like. You know, of course, you shouldn't abuse that. Do your research first before you make a purchase decision, and then once you have it in your home, listen to it, spend some quality time with it. Don't be quick to judge because your ears need to adjust to the new sound. That way you can learn from your own experiences as to what you like and what you don't like. Don't buy based on the specifications alone. If you like this video, thumbs up and subscribe. And if you'd like to support this channel, use my Amazon link below, and I'll see you guys again in my next video. Bye-bye.